Welcome to the Azure AD Architecture Deep Dive Series. My name is Gloria Lee, and I'm a program manager in the Azure AD engineering team.
Hi, I'm Ravi Vennapusa. I'm also a program manager in the Azure AD engineering team at Microsoft. So Gloria, today we are talking about device registration, right? So can you explain why Hybrid Azure AD Join is important for organizations and why they should care about it?
Yep, good question, Ravi. One of the main use cases most organizations are now focusing on zero trust and would like to leverage conditional access policy to explicitly verify. Conditional access is one of the main reasons for Hybrid Azure AD Join in your conditional access policy. You can leverage required Hybrid Azure AD Join devices to control cloud apps only to be accessed using a managed device. Remember, this setting only applies to Windows. Another reason for deploying Hybrid Azure AD Join is to enable passwordless authentication with Windows Hello for Business and FIDO 2. They have a hard-coded dependency on device registration to even get started. It really doesn't matter if your Azure AD environment is federated or not. Windows Hello for Business and FIDO 2 requires your devices to be joined to Azure Active Directory. Last, but not certainly the least, another use case is most organizations would like to leverage their investments with Intune and SCCM co-management for their Active Directory domain joined devices. To be able to automatically register your domain joined devices with any MDM, also known as mobile device management of your choice, your domain joined Windows 10 devices must be Hybrid Azure AD joined. If your device is Hybrid Azure AD joined, it provides a single sign-on to your MDM discovery endpoint, in effect, can enroll both user and devices into management scope without any user interaction. As you can see, automatic enrollment is triggered by configuring specific GPO settings, and those settings will trigger discovery of your MDM endpoint that is configured in Azure Active Directory.
Thanks, Gloria. Now that we know the importance of Hybrid Azure AD Join devices, can you explain how Hybrid Azure AD Join actually works?
Sure, Ravi. First, let's take a look at Hybrid Azure AD Join federated registration flow. Hybrid Azure AD Join triggers only when group policy object is either not configured or configured to have enable automatic device registration. Following the computer reads the service connection point from Active Directory to identify which tenant should a device register into. As a reminder, service connection point contains both tenant ID and a domain name that will be used for home realm discovery in later steps. After reading the domain name, workstation discovers whether or not the domain from the previous step is federated. That check happens by querying information from Azure Active Directory. Based on the domain federation settings, workstation is referred to the federation service, ADFS for an example. That discovered federation service challenges the workstation. For Windows authentication, interaction happens between the workstation itself and Windows Transport WS Trust endpoint on the federation service. For that reason, only WS Federation Service support registering devices. Now, in exchange for that, Windows Integrated Authentication challenges the workstation, gets a SAML token through WS Trust Channel. To reiterate, if your Federation Service is configured through SAML protocol, federated registration is not supported. In step 5, that SAML token is then passed along to Azure Active Directory to get a token for the Azure Device Registration Service to prove that authentication with on-premises federation service was successful. What's worth noting is that this step and all the steps below, it happens in the context of the local system in the workstation itself. This implies that if you have any outbound proxies in your environment or you're filtering on the edge of a network, you will need to allow either computer account authentication or whitelist the outbound traffic to Azure. Necessary ports and the URLs to be whitelisted are documented, and you can definitely find them in the links below. To bootstrap the device into Azure Active Directory, cryptographic material for the device key and transfer key are created on the device's TPM. These keys, in addition to previously issued token for Azure Device Registration Service and a certificate request, are used to register the device into Azure Active Directory. Azure DRS validates the token, creates a device object, and then creates a device certificate based on the certificate request. At this stage, the device itself will show up in Azure Portal as Hybrid Azure AD Join device. After the device registration is successful, Azure AD signs a device certificate that will be used henceforth, and the workstation itself installs that certificate into its own machine local store.
Thanks, Gloria. Should we also talk about how to validate Hybrid Azure AD Join process now?
Absolutely.
All right, let me do that then. So to validate whether the device is Hybrid Azure AD Join or successful or not, you can launch the displayed command here, dsthreadcmd/status. Highlighted portions indicate that the workstation is both Azure AD Join and domain join, indicating that the machine is Hybrid Azure AD Join. If you want to find that device in the Azure portal, use the device ID tag of the dsthreadcmd command or search by the device name displayed here. If you need more details about the process, please refer to the documentation link in the video description. An important thing to remember is that if the federated registration fails for any reason, it falls back to the managed registration flow that we'll explain in the next video. This fallback mechanism has been implemented since Windows 10 version 18.03. And finally, as you may have heard about the recent Windows 11 announcement, we want to remind you that Hybrid Azure AD Join works in Windows 11 exactly the same way it works in Windows 10. So whether you're using Windows 10 or Windows 11, you can Hybrid Azure AD Join your devices.
Thank you, Ravi. We hope you found this video useful. We will be adding videos on different topics like authentication, multi-factor authentication, governance, and many more. Please see the description below and the links to diagrams used in this video and other useful information. Thank you.
Thank you.